It's on. I've turned it on now.
Wait, you're recording now?
Yeah.
Alright, let me set up my head.
Okay, we're doing a documentary on Pat and Ray.
Just how small does my head look?
Patrick.
My name is John Marshall, and this is Matthew Simpson. We are Chasing Light Post Productions.
Your head looks really.
Let's stop. We are doing a documentary on Patrick Shepherd and James Mason.
Right. Oh, that looks good.
Oh, shit. You twat? That looks really...
Look, now you...
Oh, fucking hell! Don't touch it.
Okay.
Introduce...
It's going to be an experience, especially to anyone who's never thought about the actual process of making films.
So all you people that think it's picking up a camera and just shooting things, you're wrong.
That's what we just did.
It took ages to plan it.
All right, cut.
I'm laughing, but you're laughing at me. And I think, oh, how could this be? And I wonder if it could be the same. If it could be the same. I look around and I close my eyes just for a second and begin to cry. And I wonder if it could be the same. Could be the same.
Hi again. Yeah, we're going to be narrating as they, do their project. So we caught up with the students on their first day of pre-production. They got handed out their assignments. We caught up with Patrick and Mason to, hear their general ideas.
I'm going for, have people, has Britain lost its identity?
Oh, you're going for the British independence?
Yeah, British independence all the way.
I've been teaching the moving image students in this sector since Christmas, so about 5-6 months. Any location around the
jump? Pat,
what's the matter? Why are you talking
about that talking? Can I just have everyone's attention, please? Patrick,
I'm going
to exactly
fit
the story.
Well, what was your first impression when, meeting Patrick Shepherd?
He's sort of one of the students that didn't really sort of stand out at first.
Is that drugs? Because we can't call you guys drugs.
That's fucking disgusting. You've
got to
learn not to bum your ass.
I don't bum my ass.
Are you starting to smoke now, Patrick?
Nope. You found a fucking lighter, you bastard.
So what do you think of Patrick?
It's not bad.
I like Patrick. He's a very affable young man. He's a very nice young man. Yes, I think he's got a lot of potential there. We haven't seen too much of it so far, but I believe he's got a lot of potential.
Hippies in Britain? Keep on laughing, but one day you're going to be crushed.
What was your first impression when meeting James Mason?
He was one of the students that I sort of remembered who he was quite quickly, because he sort of stands out.
Don't throw stones at someone who's got a machine gun.
People feel cheated by Europe, and it's only fair that us, the British, should get our independence back. For too long now, we have been under the watchful eye of Europe.
I like James. He's a real cinema enthusiast. He's a big Stanley Kubrick fan, which is always a good thing in my eyes. He's a little eccentric, but that's not a bad thing. It actually benefits you to be a bit eccentric in the media industry, to be honest.
Did Drew like your idea?
He said it was too epic, too grandiose.
Well, I was a bit concerned because it seems to be such a huge idea. We are talking about 60 seconds, 2 minutes, 3 minutes kind of documentary projects we're looking at.
So, is it two days till deadline?
Yes, 2 days.
So, how do you reckon you're going to make it for the pre-production?
Possibly not, as I've only done the proposal and the treatment.
So you're 2 days away and you've only done a proposal and a treatment?
Yeah.
Okay.
What have I got to say? Right, I have equipment booking for a budget, production schedule and shot list.
Alright, what did you think of your idea? Are you still doing your thing about helping people find jobs?
Basically my idea's been changed. I'm following one person. What I'm doing is that she's hopefully going to get an interview soon for working at Tesco's. So I'm going to film her go in for an interview, come out, and then just reconstruct all the writing up the CVs and going into shops and handing it in and stuff. But I've also got other people that I'm going to interview about, you know, how they went about getting their jobs, how that interview went, and their attitude to work and stuff like that.
How do you think Drew's coping with your ideas?
I think Drew's fine with my ideas.
Yeah.
I'm still not entirely sure about where I'm going to be filming this. Because it all depends on the person that we're using, because they keep on changing this. So.
Okay, but we have discussed this.
We have.
We're now five weeks into this project. If you still haven't finalised the practicalities of your assignment or your subject matter, you need to...
Well, I know what the subject matter is. I know I can do it, even if I have to make it up.
Okay. But I'm concerned about the same thing seems to be happening again. I mean, we're now more than 50% through this unit. You still haven't finalised your subject matter.
Well, no,
I think what you need to do is go back to your proposal.
Yeah.
And if you can't have people that you can rely on to make this documentary...
Well, Robin said that I could know him, so I'm trying to help with that.
Does Robin need a job?
Yeah, Robin needs a job. He says he's looking for a job. He's not that bothered about getting a job. But if not, I could just make it up.
But remember what we said. There must be drama in your documentary.
Yeah.
There must be a desire. So unless your main character doesn't actually desperately need a job, there's no drama there. And therefore there's nothing to draw the audience in. So if Robin says he doesn't actually want a job, you haven't got much of a story here.
I suppose not. I mean, I could have a look around, but to start this Thursday deadline, I think I can get most of the work done apart from the location and health and safety.
Patrick, so that's the same thing as happened last time, isn't it? You came to me and said, okay, you want 10 things and I can do 7 of them, which is exactly what happened in drama and probably exactly what happened in advertising. Now you're more than capable, you're just as capable as he is, so how's he going to do it and you can't?
I can try and get it done by Thursday.
You have 48 hours to get it done. That's more than enough time. Okay?
Okay.
Alright.
You'll actually meet a deadline, quite.
So, he didn't tell you to do anything more?
I need to tidy up my budget plan and do a production schedule, but it's better than last time.
So you've actually done all your work for today?
Yeah.
Oh, well done.
We didn't actually catch up with James, but he did hand it all on time. Well done.
Woo! Well done, Mason!
Shot list.
I'm just going to see Dribbler when he gets off the bus.
Dribbler?
Yeah, Toby.
Alright.
Is he your crew member?
Yeah, one of them. One of the posse.
Can you name all your crew members?
Yeah. Fat Lip. Toby.
What's it like working with James?
Painful.
Spunkin. And then some people from your town.
Yes, this is Robin, the person I'm doing the documentary about.
Shalom.
Shalom. Basically, I'm keeping the same idea, it's just I'm going to have to do it differently now. Because, basically, the person that I was making the documentary about has gone and got herself a job in the pub.
He started getting really stressy with me because I was actually getting a job. And he wanted to help me get a job and he didn't actually help. So, I've kind of done it on my own, so I can't really star in his thing.
You okay?
You alright?
Yeah, it's fine. I'm surviving.
Have you filmed your documentary yet?
Almost finished. Just finishing the final pieces off.
I've got the interviews are going to be finished with the actual drama thing that Robin
Patrick,
is going to have to do.
Deadline is...
And I'd have to change any paperwork.
The deadline is 2 weeks away. Your production deadline's already gone.
No, I'd have to change the paper.
If you're going from a documentary to a documentary.
I've actually just turn the camera.
Look, why?
Simmer.
You know you should be in the car.
Oh, fuck off.
Still take place. So but it's a chance for you to take your advertising assignment to Matt and say, Matt, how do I get this one passed to America?
Okay.
It's a chance to take your scriptwriter to Bob and say, how do I get this one?
Okay, Pat, filming deadline is in, 24 hours. How much have you done?
Not a lot. Interesting thing with working on film. You can't trust anybody. Not even yourself.
and loaded them down, to then turn into still images, to then narrate over with the theme tune of Land and Hope and Glory, all explaining through images and voiceover the story of Britain and its empire. Now, as we are in the new century, although there is no such thing as an empire anymore, one more has grown, that being Europe. And a lot of people say that Europe has stolen our identity. Those were the days in which patriotism ruled, when our boys went out and fought overseas for what we wanted. We really did rule the land, and Britannia did rule the seas.
How's editing going?
Too bad.
Come outside quickly.
Sorry?
Come outside quickly.
Yes. Think about it, if you have a joy of telling stories and you have the eye and you like to come up with stories, I'm putting that very close to my face.
Sorry.
Getting very paranoid. Yeah, if you just...
What do you mean you don't know what to say?
I don't know what to say. You need to be... you need to be creative, you need to be passionate, you need to... be committed. Some days you can't go out, you've got to stay home and work. Why don't you have a camera?
Cool, we'll leave it at that.